today. So let's move on to the next session. Ladies and gentlemen, a large number of reforms are presently underway in the WPC, wireless planning and coordination wing, with reference to the management of amateur radio, our hobby. So now in session 4, we have on stage Mr. Sachin Kumar, Assistant Wireless Advisor, WPC, to tell us about the reforms in rules and regulations of amateur radio. So sir, I will request you to come on stage and share the details with sir. Please, sir, come.
Honorable dignitaries, eminent speakers, and veterans and young aspirants. I hope my presentation is there. Till the time gets ready, first let me throw the light on this fact that recently the Shanti Niketan has been awarded the title of UNESCO Heritage Site, and we are very privileged to organize and to be a part of this AM convention at this place, which has its own history. And I was remembering from one of the presentations earlier by Dr. Ramesh that recently India is also celebrating success of Aditya L1 mission, where we have started gathering the data of space weather from the sun side, and soon we'll be having very important information regarding the solar flares, solar storms. That can be very helpful to all the communications, including the ham radio. And the two presentations from earlier speakers, Jaideepar, very interestingly and briefly gave all the aspects of current ham communication, modern ham communication. So I hope the presentation is visible to all of you. So as you all may know that the WPC wing of Department of Telecommunication, it is the body for the National Spectrum Regulation, which forms the rules, policies, does the assignment for all the wireless frequencies, whether it is for a private user, individual user, defense, strategic user. And along with this national spectrum regulation, it also does the international spectrum regulation, that is managing the India's position in IT, protecting our rights, which many of us may not be aware that all the countries are having specific rights as a member of UN, as a member of ITU, in the form of use of spectrum, in the form of satellite orbits. If we will not have a specific right on the orbits, we cannot have a satellite, we cannot have specific communication, we cannot have protected strategic communication. So all these things, orbit, orbital spectrum, are protected through the International Spectrum Regulation by WPC wing in ITU. Before coming on this HAM assignment, I was also associated with the ITU radio sector work for the last almost 5 years. And before that, I was involved in the wireless monitoring station, in the terrestrial monitoring, satellite monitoring. We are having a International Satellite Monitoring Earth Station in Jalna, Maharashtra, where there is a large 14-meter satellite dish installed by the ISRO back in 1992, and it is functional even today, where we are monitoring all the satellites specifically their orbital position, we are monitoring the tolerance of the foreign satellites over Indian territory, whether they are following all the rules and regulations, they are fixed at their position, how much they are deviating. This kind of spectrum monitoring is also done by the Wireless Monitoring Organization, which is a part of WPC.
So let me come a little near to all of you. So I will also be able to see the next slide. So I'll shortly cover not as many slides as our previous eminent speakers. But yes, we have to deliver something. So I'll cover these small topics. In my short span, I have seen many of the use cases of ham radio. People are trying to use it for the benefit of social activities, for the benefit of the young engineers, for the benefit of students. So first, let us see the ITU radio regulation definition of amateur service. It is a service. In Hindi, we call it seva. But here, in the technical terms, it is one of the 40 radio communication services in the radio regulation. But in the other terms, it is a connection with the society. It is a way how we can serve our society better. On the next slide. So as ITU says, it is a service for the purpose of self-training, intercommunication, and technical investigation carried out by amateurs, that is by duly authorized persons. This is the reason why Government of India is having ASOC examination and certification process. Because an unauthorized person may not be able to properly operate on the radio frequency. That is why authorization is needed, and it should be solely with the personal aim and without any pecuniary interest, without any commercial interest. So that is the way ham community has developed itself in the service of society, in the service of nation, and it has crossed boundaries, and now with the help of ITU, AIU, international bodies, most of the hams are connected with each other and they are exchanging all the kinds of information and data for the benefit. As you all know, Government of India through the WPC link of DOT holds amateur certification examination, which is governed by the amateur rules 1978 and its subsequent amendments. The major amendment took place in 2005, where only two categories of amateurs were created, the general and the restricted category. The license fees were revised, and now a long-term licenses were awarded to all the new ham, that is 20 years and even for the lifetime. Because we have received some of the suggestions that yes, the number of hams can increase, but they can also increase revenue to the government in terms of the license fee, in terms of the examination fee. But I hope this is not the target, this is not the aim or the mission of the government to increase revenue from the ham aspect. The aim is to increase the interest within the aspects. That is why the examination fee and the license fee both are kept very, very nominal as compared to the other certifications, which we also do in terms of aviation certifications for the radio telephony and for the marine certification in terms of GMDSS exam. So the license fee is kept very nominal, 1000 rupees for the 20 years and 2000 rupees for the lifetime license. Next slide. Now, as you are all aware, that earlier the entire process was through an offline mechanism where a lot of time was taken from the exam to the license, and I think all the people who are already ham there, they have gone through this process. So among the digitization carried out by the government, the Digital India program of our Honorable Prime Minister, Department of Telecommunication, with the suggestion of various AM enthusiasts, took the step and an online process of application and processing was started on the Saral Sanchar platform of BOT. So I would also like to thank my earlier counterpart, Sri Omkar Nath Ji, who in his tenure started this, and as I listened from the people that there were many challenges in starting this online process. But now you see the time of an HAM applicant, right from the exam to the license, has reduced in terms of weeks rather than in months. And we are still in the process of simplifying it more, which I will be covering in my small presentation. So ASOC examination applications are now online, and as young aspirants, new aspirants are getting an online generated certificate. So now there is no need of getting a duplicate if the certificate is lost. You can go on the portal and download it as many times as you want. It is a digital signed copy by the officers of WKC. So currently the two series, call sign series, which are being followed, BU2 for the general category and BU3 for the restricted category. We are also in the process of modernizing this process of assignment of call sign, which is still done by the WPCV, and it will be coming in an online format. Next slide. So when I joined this unit, the first thing which came in front of me was to have suggestions from all the learned hams clubs. We had a small meeting, hybrid meeting in Delhi from our headquarters, where we tried to listen to all the suggestions from the hams, from the clubs, and we tried to invite as many as aspirants to this meeting in January. And we received lot of suggestions. From those suggestions, we worked out simplification of ASOC exam and licensing. As you can see on the left side, it was a two-step process. The candidate has to apply for exam, and then if he is successful, again he has to apply for a license. So two times candidate has to apply on the Saral Sanchar platform. So now we are in the process of simplification, and it will be a single scrutiny stage for all the HAM applicants. And two new green boxes are introduced, where auto assignment of call sign will be done from the system itself. A call sign bank is given to the system, and candidate can choose call sign of his preference from the call sign bank and pay the license fee and take the HAM license on the day he gets his HAM result. On the same day, he can receive his digital license, and that license will also have a 2D barcoded security QR code, through which it can be verified by the applicant or anyone who has a copy of the license internationally. It will be a unique QR code on the HAM license. Excellent. So these are the three major steps being taken. Auto selection of call signs, in which a new call sign series is provided to the Saral Sanchar platform. Issue of barcoded certificates, and no scrutiny for the second stage. Only scrutiny will be done at the exam time. All the documents, everything should be complete in before the exam. The candidate will appear at the exam, he will not be again asked any documents. If you have cleared the exam, you can pay the license fee, choose your call sign, and get your digitally signed license. Next slide, please. The second important change what we did was to encourage the HAM aspirants. There were HAM aspirants who had taken the exam long back, maybe 5 years, 10 years back, but could not obtain the license due to various reasons. So now, on August 23, we have created this, that those people who have appeared for the examinations and were successful, they should apply for the certification within 6 months. And it is also permitted with a very nominal late fee of ₹100 per 6 months up to 2 years. And if the candidate is coming after 2 years, then he should reappear for the HAM exam and again prove his proficiency. And the underlying reasons are that this is a very fast changing world, very fast changing radio, electronics, communications, ITU radio regulations, and even our national frequency allocation plan changes. So all the authorized person should have an updated knowledge of the international and national regulations. That is why this rule is in place. Next slide. So there is an interesting story, which a short story which I would like to share. On the 22nd of August, just one day before the Chandrayaan has landed on Moon, and we all had our fingers crossed, so we received the suggestion that a special call sign in the form of suffix, can it be awarded to the HAMs? And with our short period of that, we studied that in the radio regulations and came out that it is possible. So on the 23rd of August, on the day itself, right from the morning when our ISRO and scientists were preparing our Chandrayaan to land, we were preparing this small poem with 3-4 lines after studying all the regulations, that the special call sign suffix 3 Charlie Yankee would be awarded to all the HAMs irrespective of their request, and as per their willingness they can attach this with their call sign and use it for 1 week from 25 to 30 of August. And this request came from some of the HAM enthusiasts only. And later on, the social media division of DOT, they also celebrated this effort of the PPCV, effort from the HAM community, and put it on the Department of Telecom's social media handles like Facebook and Ask for IT. So that's all from my thank you.